back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, I'm Austin. I blog about fashion, beauty, and lifestyle in New York City, and I also make videos every Wednesday, so be sure to hit that subscribe button if you'd like to stay in touch and see more videos from me. Last week I asked a poll on my Insta stories to kind of gauge what kind of summer fashion video you guys might like to see from me, and the two options that I put up were trends and capsule wardrobe. A bunch of you really wanted to see the capsule wardrobe, and to be honest, I'm pretty with you right now. As fun as trends can be, they're not the things that stay in our wardrobe season after season, and they're not the things that we really like invest into and that we keep for years. And I think that is kind of what we should all be striving for, even though it's very tempting sometimes to want to give in to trends, and I'm extremely guilty of that too, like hello yellow gingham crop top. But that being said, I think that there is such a value in having kind of like a core wardrobe that you can build your outfits around, and I'm so excited to share mine with you all today. What I've done is selected 10 clothing items and 3 accessories that I feel are kind of the core of my summer wardrobe. I have these 10 clothing items. For a couple, I actually kind of have 2 of each to show you, because that's kind of the idea of the capsule wardrobe, is that I love them and wear them so much that I've bought either almost a duplicate or something similar just to kind of change up exactly what I'm wearing each day. So I hope you find this helpful, and let's get right into it. First item of clothing that I think is an absolute necessity is a plain black top. I know this doesn't look very summery, but when you compare it with different denim or fun accessories, you can really make it look cool. So one of the options would be like a plain black t-shirt. This one is from Brandy Melville. And then I have a tank here, which is kind of a 2018 version of it, because as you may know, square necks are very big right now, and this one is from ASOS. And I just feel like this is kind of the perfect base for your outfit, whether you start to add in a fun skirt or maybe some cool sunglasses or something like that. You really can't go wrong with a plain black top, and it allows you to be more creative with the rest of your outfit, but just know that you have something super simple and reliable that you can restyle a million different ways. Next after that is the cute white top, is what I'm calling it. So this is kind of a step above a t-shirt, but it looks more professional and polished. You could potentially style it down if you're just hanging out with your friends, or you could make it look really nice if you have like a work event, or if you're meeting someone for rooftop drinks, something along those lines. So the first one that I wanted to show you is this ruffle asymmetrical top from Boohoo, which I bought on ASOS. It's just super cute. It has a zip detail in the back and kind of a peplum hem, and it also has the ruffle going down the side. This is my go-to, I call it my brunch top. I've worn this actually to brunch on my Instagram before, so I'll pop a photo of that in here for you to see. And then this kind of silky camisole top is perfect for layering. I think even for work, this would look really cute under a blazer and with a pair of nice pants, or if you just wanted to wear it kind of around with your friends, you can definitely pair it with some denim cutoff. So these two are definitely my go-to tank, but dressy tank situations for summer. Now, no summer wardrobe, in my opinion, would be complete without a cute little dress to wear too. So I have 2 different ones to show you here. The first is from ASOS by a brand called JDY, and my friend Caitlin actually put this on her blog, and I bought it pretty much instantaneously because it's really good value for money and it's just super cute. This I've worn, you know, with a blazer before, or just with my sandals and my sunglasses, my hair in a ponytail. It looks cute no matter how you style it. And then this one over here is also from ASOS. You'll remember this from a spring haul I did a few weeks back. It's got this cool kind of cutout detail in the back. You could totally pop a cute short sleeve shirt underneath it if you're going somewhere more conservative, or just wear it as is if you're hanging out with your friends on a nice little summer night. I do realize that gingham and polka dots are very like summer 18 specific trends, but you could kind of buy these in any fabric that you want. I think the main trick is to find them in a very lightweight fabric so that you don't find yourself overheated in the summer, because I mean that can happen in New York in like 5 seconds. I leave the house and I just start sweating. The next thing that I wanted to mention is a good jumpsuit, because I feel like if you have the right jumpsuit, you are just in control of the whole universe. So I have 2 here that I want to show you. So this one is actually from last summer. It's from nastygal.com, and it has this amazing palm print, which is extremely summery. I love it. It's got also a little keyhole detail by the bust line, so you can adjust that however you want, and it's also got this really fun ruffle to it as well. This one is an extremely floaty and lightweight fabric, so I never get too hot in it, which, as I think I've already made my point, is a concern of mine, and I just love how it makes such a statement on its own, and then I can just have a really simple bag and a pair of sunglasses, and I'm good to go. This one I recently picked picked up from Forever 21, and I wore it while I was in London. If you haven't seen that vlog, I'll pop it somewhere on the screen for you. But this one is just the perfect kind of graphic print. I'm someone who wears a lot of black and white, so this fits right into the rest of my wardrobe, and I know that I can even wear it beyond summer as well. But what I loved about this was the fit was just perfect, so there were no questions about it when I was thinking about what kind of jumpsuit I wanted to buy. And I just find this extremely flattering. This is another one that you can very easily dress up or dress down. Moving on, I have two pieces of outerwear, and the next thing I wanted to talk about is the denim jacket. I have two very different jackets here, which is why I did want to show both of them. So this is actually the one that I wear the most. It is a kind of mid-wash denim. This one's from ASOS, but the back has this amazing fringe detail on it. So to me, this very much fits my personality, and that's why I consider it more of a capsule piece for me rather than a trendy one, because I've had it for, I think, almost 2 years now, or maybe a year and a half, and I wear it literally all the time. I just think it makes everything more fun, and I feel like it's kind of become one of the pieces that I might even be like best known for wearing. So this is a really great option, but if that's a little too much for you, I have this one from BDG at Urban Outfitters, and it is a super light wash one. It is a tiny bit cropped, which it's not too cropped, and I feel like this is actually the perfect length on me, and I have decided to roll up the sleeves, but you can roll them back down as well if that's the look that you prefer. But I just find this to be such a cute color, and I feel like you can make so many outfits just feel a little bit more pulled together if you have a jacket on, where you maybe don't want a thicker jacket on top of what you're already wearing and you still want to kind of just maintain your summery vibe. So in my opinion, this light wash denim is amazing. The second piece of outerwear I want to talk to you about is this white Ponte textured blazer from New Look, which I bought on ASOS, and this is probably the thing that I have worn the most in the last 30 days. The first thing I love about it was $40, which for a statement white blazer that you're gonna wear all the time is absolutely ridiculous. So definitely check this one out. I'll pop a link down to it down below in the description box. And if I can't find all of the items that I'm showing you today, as some of them might be from a season or two ago, I will always link something similar. So be sure to look down there if you're looking to do some summer shopping. This one honestly is the perfect length on me. Like, I can't explain it. I've worn it with the jumpsuit before. I've worn it over the polka dot dress. So you can already kind of see where my idea is as far as my outfit planning. I would definitely say that the colors I wear most in the summer are black and white, red, and then all of the various shades of denim, because in my mind, when I think of summer, I do think of denim a lot. But this goes with pretty much all of those things, and it just makes you look so much classier and so much more put together and sophisticated, even if the rest of your outfit is kind of having a more laid-back moment. So this is probably the best purchase I made of the summer. Let's just put that out there. And I have a whole blog post about how to style this, which I will link down below if you'd like to check out. The ice cream truck that likes to circle my block in the summer is making its rounds right now, so I'm going to talk quickly before it thwarts my video. I am now going to move on to bottoms, and be warned, there is a lot of denim ahead of you. The first thing I wanted to talk about is the perfect pair of denim cutoffs, and I have to say, people are always surprised because this is definitely my most worn pair of denim shorts, and people are always like, oh my god, your shorts, oh my god, where are they from, where are they from? Guys, American Eagle denim. Don't know why, it's just fantastic. I like that it's stretchy, but it doesn't look stretchy. Like, you know when someone's wearing a pair of like denim jeggings or something and you can just tell that they're not real denim? Like, this definitely feels like denim and looks like denim, but it does have that stretch to it, which makes it so much more comfortable. And I'm someone who really does value comfort in fashion. Like, I can't wear those dainty little high heels. I can't wear things that just have too much fuss going on with them. I always really need to be comfortable. So this has been my go-to pair. This, I believe, is a mid-rise style. I will try to find the exact ones and link them below for you, but all of their denim is great, so definitely check it out. And then the other pair I wanted to talk about was this pair from BDG Urban Outfitters. This doesn't have any rips in it, so if you're looking for kind of just a more laid-back, plain, but still more polished denim short, I would definitely check some of their styles out too. Keeping on a denim theme here, the next thing I wanted to talk about is the denim mini skirt. So this is a classic. If you grew up around the same time I did, you know in the fifth grade we were all rocking them from Abercrombie and Hollister, but thank god they've gotten cooler and just less annoying, because Hollister and Abercrombie. If I could have back every dollar I ever spent there, I would. Who do I call about this? So I picked up this one from Topshop last summer, and I'm pretty sure they roll out like either exactly this or something super similar to it, but it's from their Moto range, and it is just a perfect kind of mid-wash denim mini skirt. It has a little bit of fraying going on at the end, but as you can see, it's not like falling apart or anything, which can be one of my pet peeves with denim if it's like too distressed. And then this is another cool option. This one's from Levi's. This one does have a little bit of distressing, but like the biggest distress mark over here also has another piece of denim behind it. So you kind of just get a little bit of skin showing there, nothing too crazy. But I feel like this is the perfect thing to wear with kind of more trendy tops. Like if you do want to do a bit of trend shopping for summer, for example, maybe the top I'm wearing now would be great to pair with one of these, but it's kind of just good as another option if you're not really in a shorts mood and it's too hot to wear pants. So definitely find yourself a denim mini. Even though it's summertime, if you love jeans like I do, you'll still probably find yourself reaching for them every once in a while. And this pair from DL1961 are my absolute all-time favorite pair of jeans. These are the Goldie high-rise jeans, and they've got a slightly distressed hem, but they don't have any distressing on the main part of them, so it's just at the bottom, which I like. These are honestly just the perfect summer jeans. So they're a straight leg jean, they're not skinny, and you still feel like you can breathe in them, and the denim is so soft. It's just like the comfiest, nicest, best thing ever. And this with a little tank top, even on a day that it's hot, is kind of just perfect. There's nothing more perfect than that. So these jeans are amazing, and DL1961 makes lots of different cool jeans that I love, so definitely check them out if you haven't heard of them yet. And the last thing in the bottom section, this is not denim, you'll be very excited, but these are a pair of pants I picked up from Bershka. They have a pop-up in Soho right now, so I was able to go in person, which I was very excited about. And they've got kind of this like houndstoothy checked pattern to them, which is awesome. And they also are slightly cropped at the bottom, and this part is rolled up. And I just feel like even in the midst of summer, style can feel very casual, but if you do work in an office or you feel like you want to kind of keep yourself a little bit dressed up in the summer months, it's great to have a pair of lightweight but polished looking bottoms to go to. So these are great. These would look really cute with either of the little floofy white tops that I showed you earlier, or if you're just having a more kind of chill day, I would pair them with maybe the black tank top and a pair of slide-on shoes for a more laid-back look. But yeah, I feel like tailored stuff is everywhere lately. I suppose we kind of have Hillary Clinton to thank for that, and I'm just rocking it. I'm like all about this trend right now. I keep buying blazers and keep being very attracted to like suits and matching sets and things like that. Earlier in this video I said I had 3 accessories to show you, but it's actually 5, but they're all super important. So what I meant was I have 2 bags to show you, 2 pairs of shoes and 1 pair of sunglasses. The first bag that I want to talk about is kind of a more statement style bag. So this is a bag I picked up from Mango in the fall maybe, and as you can probably tell, it is basically a dupe for the JW Anderson Pierce bag. But I love this bag just because if the rest of my outfit is more neutral, as you've seen in kind of the capsule collection of what I have shown you so far, this kind of adds that really wow moment to an outfit, and it looks so nice. I've had this bag for a while and have not scratched it or anything. It was pretty cheap quality, and I've recently found some similar options because I can't find this on Mango's website, so those will be down below for you to check out. But it's got this cool gold strap, and it is just a summer bag that makes me very happy. Next, I want to show you something from probably my favorite handbag designer, Rebecca Minkoff. This is the Moto Mini Satchel, and I wear it most often as a crossbody. I also have this bag in black. If you've watched my What's in My Bag video from like a long, long time ago, you'll remember that. I love this bag just because it really brightens up a look more than a black bag would, especially for a summer outfit, and I feel like that just kind of makes me happy. So this is a great alternative to a black bag. If you are worried about getting it dirty, just know that I've had this bag for about a year now, and I finally got it dirty, but I think that was my fault because I was out at a bar and I put it on the floor. But anyway, back to the nice side that I only use for Instagram. This is a fantastic bag, and it was super affordable. It holds way more than it looks like it holds, and this is just one of my favorite summer bags. Moving on to shoes, I don't think any city girl's summer wardrobe is complete without the right pair of trainers. So these are my Adidas Superstars. They're kind of the OG classic in my mind, but you could also find some from like Converse and Vans. Basically any summer sneaker that just makes you happy and that you feel like you can wear with a bunch of different stuff. I also think every good summer wardrobe needs a pair of black sandals. I picked up these from Miss Selfridge on ASOS, and I also have a belt that looks a lot like this. It's kind of Western inspired, so that's kind of what first attracted me to them. And I also just liked the heel height because, again, if I'm wearing these running around New York in the summer, I really don't want to feel slowed down by the fact that I can't walk in my shoes. So I loved that about these, and I just think they're so cute, and they go well with jeans or cutoffs or skirts, and you can also make them look super sophisticated and dress up, or you can just throw on your cutoffs and a t-shirt and kind of run about your day. So that's what I loved about these. And the last thing that I wanted to share with you guys is my all-time favorite pair of sunglasses. glasses. So these are just a black cat eye style. They are very simple and I just think they look really sophisticated and really amazing. And guess what? They're from Amazon Fashion. Seriously, these are like $11 on Amazon Fashion, and if you have Prime, they obviously ship to you in 2 days. So I am obsessed. I just can't say enough good things about these. If you're hoping to up your sunglasses game at a very affordable price, definitely check out Amazon Fashion sunglasses. I don't know why they're so good, they just are. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please like it and leave me a comment down below. Tell me what your favorite item is and what you are looking for in your summer capsule wardrobe. If you really, really liked this video, subscribe to my channel or maybe share it with a friend who you think would enjoy it. I always love to be able to reach new people and talk to you all and see what I can help with, and hopefully you found this video useful if you're doing a little bit of summer shopping. Thank you all for watching and I hope you have a great day. I'll see you in my next video. Bye!